Dr. Herman, I want to thank you for coming out tonight. Senator Cook and I, I think we were first ones to talk about a public forum and how important it would be to get information out to the public so they knew what was going on. I look forward to working with you in the future, see if we can accomplish our common goals and maybe pull you towards an emergency room. I do want to say a couple of things, though. Number one, you made the statement, you can only do what you can do. Well, the reality is that Biden Health decided to close our hospital without reaching out to Hyde County, Beaufort County, or the town of Bellhaven, or the town of Bath, Pantigga. You didn't ask for any help. You knew what you wanted to do, and you did. You should have reached out to the communities. It causes doubt in people's minds when people see you not reach out, as if that was your goal to start with. So that's a problem. So you say you did all you could do. You didn't do all you could do. And it's not, I'm not trying to jab at you or anything, but you did. And we're here talking about facts. I never got a call, the county commissioner never got a call, and we might could have impacted your decision and made it even better for Biden Health. The other thing is the emergency room. I was accosted outside by former chairman of your Biden board, Rocky Jacobs, about emergency room procedures and drugs or whatever. And he was telling me that all the ER facilities will be at the new clinic. There aren't any there, won't be there. Well, I remember when we met at Plumbing District Hospital and I sat across the table with you and I talked about the clot busting drug. And you told me it wouldn't be there. And I know that through this process we've all learned some things and worked out all the details and that sort of thing. And I appreciate that and I give you the benefit of the doubt for that. But tonight, I think you've represented, I think the people agree with me, you've represented that the 24/7 facility that will fill the gap and the new facility will basically have all the emergency room procedures and drugs and resources that our current emergency room has, except blood. Can we get a pledge from you that that's true?
Blood, you won't be able to get. Whether we can have emergency CT scan available, which we really don't have now, we can't promise that, but there'll be emergency x-ray stuff and all that stuff. So the drugs to stabilize people, as we have right now, and the same skilled people that are in that room right now, we have their pledge, and they'll be in that room going forward. So unless there's something that of which I am unaware, you have my pledge.
Well, Dr. Herman, then, I think everyone in this room agrees that the main issue here is making sure that all the life-saving skills are there from here out. And it seems like to me blood and a CT scan are the only two admissions to the new facility. So why doesn't Biden consider working with the county commissioners, the towns, and see if we can't get those other services in place? Maybe the county governments can help you in some way. But they are willing to help. I know unanimously that county commissioners are very concerned. I know that the board of Bellhaven is very concerned. And I think the gap between what you're doing and the minimum that we can stand is not that far. But we got to talk to each other. We got to figure out how to bridge that gap so that we don't have a man eaten up by a boat motor that dies. You know, and you say, hey, that happens once a year. Well, that's once a year somebody dies. Now, I know you don't know that.
I didn't say that.
So anyway, thank you for coming. I look forward to working with Biden and trying to get a solution to the issue that we have that we're apart. And I hope that Biden looks forward to working with us. I think it would be great to have a committee with some county commissioners on Beaufort County, Hyde County, the Bellhaven Board, get together and talk over the differences here. Let's try to figure a way to do something that these people can be happy. We're not happy about losing jobs. We're not happy about losing our hospital. But there is a minimum that we can't go without. And we have to do whatever we have to do to make sure that minimum is met. So thank you for coming out.
Thank you. Before I wrap this up, time close, I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. Thank everybody for the respectful conversation that we've had. Thank you very much.
Just to wrap up real quick, folks, before you go, I'm Representative Paul Tyne, and I was asked to sort of end the session and thank everybody. First of all, I know how frustrating this is. I've heard from a lot of you and heard a lot of your discussions and heard from you, obviously, here tonight. And I want to thank you for being respectful in the way that you brought those those concerns forward. Two things that I think, if I could summarize your concerns, one of them is obviously emergency services, and the mayor just spoke with him, and I think that we have a commitment there that we didn't understand we had before we came into this room. So, you know, I know when you're frustrated, you want to talk, and you don't want to listen. And I'm the same way. I want to come out swinging instead of listening to what you have to say. But I hope now that we've had a chance to let them know what our concerns are, that now we'll listen and see what's the best situation we can come out of this that we possibly can. Quite frankly, nobody's going to be happy at the end of this. I mean, we're not going to have the same level of services. They've made that clear. And it's going to be very difficult for us to do that on our own. But we want the very best out of this, and we know that EMS, the emergency services, is one of those spots that we just can't give any ground. The second thing that we also have heard, and I know Biden heard it also, and I think that it's actually more than a suggestion, it's actually a demand. They must involve the community more in communication as they move through this process. And tonight was an important part of that. They came here and they listened and they communicated and they responded. So I'd like to thank Biden also for being here this evening to start that communication, because we lost a lot of trust in this process and it takes a while to build that trust back up. So let's start taking some steps forward that we might be able to build that trust again. I want you to let you know that Senator Cook and myself are committed to making sure we have the best solution that we have here, that we can have. And along with the mayor and our commissioners in Beaufort County, I want you to know that my cell phone is on the website. Feel free to use it. If there's a piece that you don't think is coming true based on our conversations today, give me a call. I want to hear about it. I want to know that we're moving in the right direction based on your understanding of your conversations today. So with that, I'll thank the mayor for hosting this, Senator Cook, the gentleman from Biden, and all of you for being here tonight. Thank you.